So it's good to handle the kids. by Daniel Powers, and we will be replacing it with a piano piece called Publicly Alone by an Anonymous Composer. If you want to hear Manchester Hymn, go to Public Works on April 27th. Yeah. I'd also like to thank RJ Dion, Christie Echols, Zach Stowe-Alkman, and Leo Florence for being stage and set crew for this concert. I would like to thank Laura Young for taking pictures. And, yeah. Thank Dr. Jill Lyons for supporting us the entire way and helping us, like, get what we needed.
Don't come out here much. Neighbors, we are. to begin with. Thank you. called Hadestown, which is a modern, folky kind of retelling of two Greek myths, the one of Orpheus and Eurydice, and the one of Hades and Persephone. And this song in the musical is the first song where Eurydice kind of starts to fall in love with Orpheus. So enjoy.
I'm gonna sing my song. All the good of the lost and alone. why should I be afraid to trust myself to you? In this communion of souls, we are God's hors d'oeuvres. As he picks his teeth with your bones, the devil laughs. Love breaks my bones and I laugh. I roll you onto your side and your snoring stops. Let the light in. The balloons sink. Yesterday's refuse is gathering flies. Why should I be afraid to trust myself to you? I plucked you from the vine. I sank my teeth into your tender spine. Love breaks my bones and I laugh. Morning peers into your burning eyes. In the air, there's a layer of dust, a transitive grime. From the floor, I watch in terror as you arise. To consume or to be consumed, spoken in whispers around the house or written on street signs, above the lights, across. I'm among the verdant grasses, melding with the greenery, eaten alive, eating among the fireflies, mindlessly interceding death. I have written over the doors, prepared the rooms, filled the lanterns, detuned the strings, buried the roads to see or to have been seen, holding a knife to someone's throat. It's in the mirror in the hallway. It's marked with a gravestone out back. I would die for you, I said. Over the entryway, driven across the doorstep, I'm above the setting sun, to be alone or just to be. There is victory spoken in whispers around the house. Crawling perpendicular to death, I have prayed for rain. I have closed my eyes. On my knees, I awoke to consume or to be consumed. I have lifted you to my lips. I have written over the doors. I have seen you in the streets. I can feel you now. Yes, even now I can feel you. I can feel you now. Yes, I can feel you. God, how dark it is in here. Amidst sleep resides a damp heat, metallic, sticky, and sweet. For fear, I have no use. I once had everything I need. You joyously licked the wounds clean. You took what I gave. You set me ablaze. The woods we quietly raised. We used to sit beneath whichever tree had the least anthills, carefully unpeeling chestnuts in the dog days of summer. Heads lolling out of windows, breathing in the sultry air. You took me home. You carried me in. Your presence divine. You opened my chest. You slid off my skin. You lit me again. My eyes grow weary in the night. I have lost the writhing ghost of your body. In here, the sun doesn't rise. I used to know what I lacked. Once this was more than a cave. You were here before. After you left, I chewed a hole through my cheek calling your name. God, how dark it is. God, how dank. A simple man, dripping in gold, my king, a king of kings, begat from soot, sheathed in silt, solid like stone. What is the voyage of the soul? Who will tend thy flock? Who will manifest? Whose body is the radiant vessel, whose cracks are mended with gold? I am waiting. I aim to be weightless, shapeless even. I am afraid the blood is seeped through the door. I fear your liberation tainted the halls. My fields are barren. I pray I never hear his voice, his wicked siren's call. The pit in my gut is sprouting wildly, feeding, consuming. I used fire to warm the water. Beneath the surface, submerged my head, the tension withholding silence. In the absence of light, underneath it all, preserving the calm, ordinarily quiet. Many deaths I'll sing, recanting, refracting, hands clasped tightly, alight. With me, I will carry the end of days for the rest of my life. When I bring myself to look in the mirror, I nearly weep. Foraging in groves and skeletons, in deserted towns and homes has made me restless. For answers, I would do anything. Here, I beheld the fire and the wood. For you, I prepared the slaughter. I dared you to question. I did as you asked. To whom do you belong? I have seen the foolish taking root. I have felt the soil slipping through my hands. You guided me to plant the trees. You bade me to consume the ripened fruit. You lifted me to your lips. Amidst the thickened vines, above the twisted branches, we slept, sheltered against the weather from above and below. Here I held you and spoke your name. Here we became intertwined. For offerings, I helped you crack open the earth. I never knew the holes were essentially graves. Once I was enough, enamored with the blaze. Now alone, I gaze upon our fallen kingdom. And then, like God, I laugh. Again and again and again and again, here I am professing, weeping, and for what? And for whom? Everything is gliding gracefully apart, everything falling deeper again, death approaching, advising, with serrated teeth, stranding, perpendicular to meaning, engaging the fruits of my labor, beating and berating my aching spine again and again and again and again. I would die for you, I said. Or were you not listening? Did you not hear when I yelled your name, when I spelled it out, when I returned again and again and again, and I ripped the grime straight from my face, I burned my skin, I prayed for rain, on my knees I awoke, sins, Julienne, to expunge you again, to ensnare you again, I've entangled the walls, I've spared no expense, I've ravaged the floors, ripping deeper within, pulling shrapnel and rot from my roots, from my chin, from your throne I envisioned, I felt you again, I can feel you again, yes, I feel you again, I can feel you again, yes, I feel you again. Why should I be afraid to trust myself to you? You ripped open the curtains. You said, let there be light. I never considered your love burning bright. Come closer to me. Can you feel the warmth of the sun? Can you feel the vastness, the sheer emptiness of your earthly desertion? Why should I be afraid to trust myself to you? You who shimmered like gold, you who blossomed tenfold, come closer to me. In the mirror, I whisper your name. You never appear. I am burdened alone. I am waiting here. Come closer to me. To me, come close.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. So I'm going to go ahead and start the next piece. This is entitled Love.
Is there something better? Is there something better? Thank you.